My name is Steven Chilaya, Assistant Professor of AAA Department, Saint Martin's Engineering College. So, okay, today I will discuss a BWD subject. So, this subject mainly, first of all, initially we will be discussing passive elements. So, the network passive elements. So, the network passive elements are resistance, inductance, capacitance. Okay, right. So these are the basic circuit passive elements. Okay, so active elements are also there. So but today we are discussing only on passive elements. Right. So in this passive elements generally that we are looking for in any network combination that we are representing in electrical point of view, that we are representing by using only this RLC elements. Okay. So the passive network resistance elements, the inductive elements and capacitive elements. So those connections will be there. So generally these elements generally we are connecting either in series or in the parallel combination of both. Okay. So that will be different combinations are there. So first of all we will discuss with the resistance in series combination. Okay, in series combination resistance that we will discuss. Okay, so let us assume two resistors. These two resistors resistance values are R of R. These two are connected in series combination. Okay, so in series combination, the current going through these two elements in this. Okay, right. So this is the resistor that we are giving current that is going through these elements is I. Okay, so here apply this. Usually it is a DC supply. So if this DC supply voltage, so here after flowing current either through this elements and here some drop, so that the drop is the resistance V1 across the R, and another drop is V2 across R, right. Okay. Now whenever the KVH, okay, now I am applying KVH in this second area, it is the closed circuit. Because at these two terminals we are connected a DC source. Usually it is a dependent voltage source. Okay, after applying the KVL expression in this circuit is, so I will start from here. So minus V, that is the voltage that is existing across these two terminals, minus V plus that voltage drop across this R1. Okay, so plus I1 R1 is a plus I2 R1. Is equal to 0. So now V is equal to I1 R1 plus I2 R. Okay. Now if we take the common, in these two elements, so here not I2 is I1 because the same current is also going to R1. Okay. So here common term is I1. So take I1 common here. Remaining term is R1 plus R1. Then is equal to resistance. Let us assume the equivalent resistance across these two supply terminals is R equal. If the resultant equivalent resistance across these two elements is R equal, then the voltage existing across these two elements is V. Then we can write an expression, voltage expression in terms of power current and current. Yes, sir? So by using Ohm's law. So that expression is V is equal to I1 into R. So this is the expression. Take this equation as 2. Now compare equation 1 and 2. Both equations are same. Okay. Right? So I'm comparing here the equation 1 and 2. I1 R equivalent is equal to I1 R equivalent is equal to I1 into R1 plus R. I1 into R1 plus R. So here both sides I1 and I1 are the same. So remaining expression is R equivalent is equal to R1 plus R. So if two resistors are connected in series combination, then their equivalent resistance value is R sub. So like this, suppose if you are connected n number of resistors in series combination. Suppose if n number of series resistors are connected is equivalent resistance will be equivalent resistance will be that R equivalent is equal to R1 plus R2 plus and so on. So this is the right n resistors are connected in series. So same similarly we can also derive if the resistors not resistors inductors. So inductors in series combination is capacitors in series combination. Okay, so I will directly write for the expressions. Otherwise you can derive the answer. Right, instead of considering the resistors, counting inductors. These inductors, inductance values are L1 and L2. So this inductor inductance value is L1 and this inductor inductance value is L2. Okay. So now we apply KVL here. So the same KVL expression is minus V plus the voltage drop across L1 is L1 into the current flowing through that element is I1 di1 by V plus another expression is the voltage drop across L2 that is the inductor is L2 into D I2 by V is equal to C. Now D is equal to L1 into D I1 by V plus L2 into D I2 by V. That is equation as well. Now let us assume the total equivalent inductance across the separate terminals. That let us assume as L. Then if total inductive inductance value is L, then total voltage drop of us is L1, L equivalent to D I1 by V is the expression. Take this expression. Equation. Now compare these two. Okay? Now compare these two equations. Okay? So after comparing, L equivalent into di2 di1 by dt is equal to L1 into di1 by dt plus L2 into di2 by dt is the expression. Okay? Now take common here di1 by dt. Now right hand side. Okay. Right hand side. Left hand side term as this. L equal to di1 by dt plus equal to here I am taking di1 by dt as 1. Okay. Now take integration on both sides. Integration on both sides. So after taking integration, so here already a differential operator is there on both sides. So after taking integration, both differentiation and integral both are there, get transferred. So right hand side, L equivalent into I1 u and left hand side term. And right hand side term is L1 plus L2 into I1. So anyway, here I1 on both sides, both are get transferred. So next. After cancellation, remaining L equivalent expression is L1 plus L2. So which means that if any two inductive elements or inductors are connected in series combination, then they will result in an equivalent, that is equivalent inductance value is sum of the individual inductance values, that is L1 and L2. Okay, so like this, if you suppose n number of inductors connected in series case, okay, L equivalent to L1 plus L2 plus and so on. So this is the equivalent inductance value that n number of inductors are connected in series. Okay, right. So now another combination that we do, that is capacitance. Okay. So now replace inductor value by capacitance. This is the capacitor symbol. This capacitance value is C1 and this value is C2. And net equivalent C here across these two elements. Equivalent to the capacitance value is S is C equivalent. Okay, right? So now we also apply KVL initially. So what is the KVL equation? Minus V plus. So the voltage drop across this C1 element, okay, that is 1 by C1 integral of I1 plus, and another voltage drop across C2 is 1 by C2 integral of I2. So anyway, here I2 and I1 both are same. So the same current going through these two elements. So here you can directly write I2 is equal to C1. Now we get the same equation, V is equal to 1 by C1 integral of I1 V2 plus 1 by C2 integral of I2. Now take here common on right hand side, integral of I1 V2. Okay, so after taking common, this is the V is equal to 1 by C1 plus 1 by C2 integral of I1. Right? So take this equation as well. Now another equation is if we're assuming that total equivalent capacitors value of those two series capacitors is C equivalent. In that case, the voltage expression is V into 1 by C equivalent integral of I1 dt is the expression. Okay? So take this equation as well. Now compare equations 1 and 2. Right? So after comparing both equation 1 and 2, 1 by C equivalent is equal. 1 by C equivalent integral of I1 dt is equal to 1 by C1 plus 1 by C2 integral of I1 dt. This is the now differentiate on both sides. Okay? Differentiate on both sides. So after differentiation, any integral operator is there. So after differentiation, both the operators are cancelled out. So the remaining expression of cancellation is 1 by C equivalent into I1 is equal to, okay, 1 by C1 plus 1 by C2. So here I1 and here I1, both I1 terms are both capable. So after simplification, 1 by C equivalent, so after cancellation, 1 by C equivalent is equal to 1 by C1 plus 1 by C2. So from this equation, what is C equivalent? C1, C2 by C1 plus C2. This is the expression. When two capacitors are connected in series combination case, the equivalent capacitance value is C1 into C2 by C1 plus C2. Like this, suppose if you are connected n number of capacitors in series combination. Okay? So in that case, we will get here 1 by C equal to